Okay.
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 Okay. Okay.
Today.
Today.
We
are going to be
discussing.
Discussing.
Today. Today, we're welcoming you to the Dickie Dine Show, and we are going over lies that parents told us when we were children.
Bunch of liars.
Bunch of liars, man. The one, I'll start it off myself. The one that I was told is that if you sit in a car that's running for too long, it will kill the car. Have you ever been told that?
If you sit in a car for too long.
That's running. It will kill the car.
Oh yeah, I learned that was false while listening to a Day to Remember like tour thing. They were just like, yeah, we just sleep in the van with it running. I was like, yeah, that, like destroy it.
Right. Yeah, my parents were like, you're like, don't sit in the car with the AC running. You're gonna kill the car. You're gonna like flood the engine. I'm just like, what?
Hold on, mom. What? Dude, I also have a good one before we start. I'm pretty sure you're aware of this one, but this was like mega embarrassing when it happened. My whole life, I was told by my mom that you had to, when you jumped like a car, that you had to take the cables and drop them on the ground afterwards because that way the electricity would leave the cords.
What?
And so I was just like, yeah, sure, okay. I don't want to get shocked. So the situation was that it was your friend that was over. He's like an electrician guy.
Okay, gotcha.
Anyway, your buddy was there, and somebody was leaving your house, and they were like, oh yeah, I gotta go jump my car, and I was like, make sure you drop the cables on the ground after you're done so you don't get shocked. And he went, what are you talking about? I was like, what? And he's like, that's not how electricity works, dude. And then he explained it to me. I was like, yeah, that makes a lot of sense. I don't know why. I guess it was just something I always believed because my mom told me that when I was really young. And I was just, I've been doing that my whole life. Yeah, like, okay, I'm done now. Drop them on the ground. Now pick them down. They're good.
I hope, people like, watching you like, what is he doing?
Yeah, dude, I've done it with people that are like, oh, thanks for your help. Just, and I was like, yeah, hold on one sec. Why did you do that? Okay. No, not a single person ever asked me. They were just like, I don't know, wait, should I do that? Am I gonna get electrocuted?
All right, let's start. When I was very young, we had a stereo that had huge speakers. It was in the late 70s. My dad told me that there were little people inside them who played the music. I used to stand in front of the speakers and feel the vibrations on my face while I tried to see them. I kind of remember being told something like this, but it was more like little people in like cupboards. Like, did you ever see the Indian in the cupboard? Mm-hmm. More so like that. I was told that little gnomes or little people like live inside like places.
Huh. Dude, that would be terrifying. I feel like that would have freaked me out more than helped me in a comforting way.
My parents would say stuff like, oh, there's little hamsters running wheels inside the car. But I thought I think they were just being like, oh, being cute, you know?
Right.
They weren't.
How many liars
like,
can we tell this idiot before he catches on? how long can we bully our five-year-old?
Mom used to tell me if I ate apple seeds, a tree would grow in my tummy. Generally made me fear apples.
You just have to smoke cigarettes and it'll suffocate the seeds.
That my parents were virgins until marriage. When I found out about it, my mom said, I never said I was. I strongly implied it, and you assumed.
She's gaslighted her kid. Listen, I never broke the rule.
Right, yeah. So to start off, I really love chocolate milk. And when I was a kid, my dad was a milk delivery driver, and he always used to tell me that chocolate milk came from brown cows. And I legit believed this until I was about 13. I was told that too.
Yeah.
I've been told everything, dude. Like,
right.
I heard all of them.
Yeah, that's a fair. I feel like a lot of kids believe that one.
Yeah,
or might even just assume that. Because,
or a chocolate milk cow, like a different kind of cow.
When I was in elementary school, the chocolate milk had like a chocolate cow
on
it. So
right.
You're like,
very
oh,
easy.
That must just be a real thing.
Very easy to believe.
A brown cow that dispenses chocolate naturally. It must eat cacao plants, clearly.
Nathan Smith says, when the ice cream truck was playing music while driving through the neighborhood, that it was an alarm that they were sold out of ice cream.
Ooh, what? Dude, the betrayal. I bet you were devastated. Just the look.
Douche move.
Looks back at his parents. What the? Are you kidding me?
I have never been told or heard that one.
Yeah.
And that I feel very
I just love that he never questioned it too. He's like, why is he driving through the neighborhood slowly, being like, hey, I'm sold out, yeah. And just go home.
Yeah, like, right?
And just never question that.
Yeah. That if I ate my boogers, they would grow into my brain. I held on to that one for way too long.
I'm okay with you thinking that, to not eat your boogers.
Right. Well, yeah, true. I was told that boogers are like dead brain cells.
Whoa.
Yeah.
That's full. You're like, my leaking brain.
Yeah, I was told essentially that like when your brain cells die, that's what boogers are.
Were you raised by a Candyland instructions guide? What the fuck are all these weird fantasies you were told?
I was raised in the middle of nowhere. My parents, who didn't have the internet and were very gullible. Logan Garrett says, I wasn't allowed to kill flies because I was told each one had a name and a day job to feed his family.
He was taught to value death early, I guess.
That would be something that wouldn't be a bad thing, I think, to tell your...
Mid-hit? Whoa, son! Think of his family. What? That little fly probably has a wife and kids, just like you at home. What? Six dead flies in his hand? What?
My me says that my dead cat used to write to me from heaven. They would even add a paw print as their signature.
Your cat would write.
And they would add a paw print on the note as a signature.
Right, they probably had like a stamp or something, yeah. Just a paw print stamp. You know, once your cat dies, it goes to heaven, and then the first thing it's taught is cursive.
Yeah, I could see, here's the thing, I could see if your child was so, so distraught.
Mm-hmm. You just like needed to wean them off it.
And it was just like, okay. Mm-hmm. I need to do this thing, like maybe once or twice, and then stop.
Right.
But they did it so many times. Right.
Receive a letter from my dead animal.
Right. Well,
like, yo, what the
fuck? Well, and that's something that you could just never bring up again until you're older, and then you can say, well, yeah, like, because animals write, you know.
Dude,
and then
everyone looks at you like,
in like high school, you bring it up again.
Yo, are you doing a bit?
Like, what the fuck? And then you're the outcast.
No, look, they're in my bag. I have 35 notes from all my dead animals, guys.
Yeah, shared this information.
You guys don't have dead animal notes?
Jesse Ashford says, if I drew on myself with a pen, I would get ink poisoning.
I was told that one too.
Yes.
I thought that for a while.
Literally until reading it here.
You're like, yo, whoa.
Well, not ink poisoning, but that it would like
seep into your
skin.
Seep into your skin
and be toxic.
Shit. Yeah. Well, I feel like that one's because it's like stemmed, because like graphite, like way back in the day, used to be toxic
chemicals
and shit. So
now it's not.
Mm-hmm. Right. It's probably just one of those things that like our parents in their heads are still like, hey, I heard this when I was 7. Don't eat graphite.
Yeah, right. I think it's the same thing. My mom told me that if you eat the donuts in the store, they're free.
Can you imagine? Damn, that's just a bad mom. That's a mom that takes the whole bowl of candy.
Yeah.
Your mom's selfish.
That mom is setting her son up to get arrested.
Yeah, and then be like, where did I go wrong? Yeah. Why does Jimmy steal?
Krista Henthorne says that Santa's elves were watching my every move. If I misbehaved, they'd report me and I wouldn't get any presents. Believe that one till I was like 10.
Right outside their window.
Right.
Is that Newgrounds? Bad kid! They're on the hentai part of Newgrounds!
Right.
A bunch of little elves standing on top of each other. What's going on there? You open up? You being naughty?
If you swallow gum, it prevents you from pooping.
Oh,
I heard if you swallow gum, it stays in your stomach.
For like 7 years.
I heard 7 days.
I heard 7 years.
Heard 7 years?
Yeah, they really didn't want me to swallow gum.
Gonna get it out.
Yeah, I remember I freaked. I made myself throw up the first time I actually swallowed gum.
Oh my
I was like laughing and I like, I was like,
this is why you don't lie to your kids.
Yeah, because be honest with your kids.
You make him throw up. Rachel Seitz says that it was illegal to have the cab light on inside the car while driving.
The most common.
Or that if I crossed my eyes too much, they'd get stuck that way. Both, I was told as well.
Yeah, the face thing.
I was lied to a lot.
Dude, my mom.
As a kid.
So a lot of these I was told, but my mom buckled under pressure. So like I'd be like, really? She'd be like, no.
Yeah.
Immediately, no, I just don't want you to do it. Okay.
My parents told me that when I left school, I'd miss it. I left school a year early because the bullies hospitalized me. Still to this day, I want nothing to do with that place. I did not miss it when I was 15 when I left. I'm 21 now. I've had messages from some people from school asking to go for apology drinks, which I declined. Yeah, I think that's more so the parent projecting their own, I miss high school because that was the best time of my life.
Yeah, that's that should make you feel better because that just means that your parents peaked in high school and you still have time.
Yeah, they want to vicariously live through you. Isaac Bardovsky says, people who are small smoked as a kid. I heard
that too, I forgot about that, whoa.
I heard people who are small drank coffee as a kid because it stunted their growth. Which maybe it does still, I don't know.
Caffeine
but,
and cigarettes, yeah, I heard both those.
My dad was dead when he's alive in a different country on the other side of the world.
Lol.
Yeah, can you imagine that one? Like, you thought your dad was dead your whole life? Well, he's alive.
101, how to feel completely alone in the world.
Yeah, seriously.
Oh, I have a dad? And I just thought he was dead this whole time?
Yeah.
That's how little he cares about me? Yeah, rest in peace, your self-confidence. I'm sorry. Hope you get better.
When my brother and I were little kids, our parents would give us an extra hour to play Banjo-Kazooie if we behaved well. Turns out that extra hour was so they could have a quickie.
Yo, Banjo-Kazooie, are you really complaining, dude? Your parents gave you an hour of free Zooey time? Let them... Banjo, that's a great game. If you were playing Battle Tanks with your... Like, I'd be like, whatever, but... Come on, Banjo-Kazooie with the... That's sick.
Tony Barr says that my uncle and the guy he lived with were just really good friends. Good friends who have lived together since the 70s. I mean, I get it, man. It's a different time back then. You want to be careful.
It's just so weird.
To each his own.
Call your lover, like... Hey, uncle? This is your uncle, by the way.
This is friends.
Oh, yeah, like... my mom and uncle all the time. Yeah.
Thomas Barnes says, my mom and dad always used to say that if I sit too close to the TV, my eyes would go square.
Square?
This one was also on there a lot.
It like molds to the shape of the TV.
Yeah. He says, I'm still confused as to what it means. I don't know either, but.
It's like I feel like there's a couple of these where parents took the very typical ones and just tweaked them a little bit to be like, no, see, this is like unique. I changed it a little bit.
Right.
This way it'll really scare
them. Yeah. I have honestly heard probably like 90% of those growing up.
I've heard maybe three to four of those.
I heard like almost all of them.
Damn.
I have so many problems.
Yikes.
There's some ones there that I forgot about.
Yeah, you said a couple of them. Like the stunting your growth one. I totally forgot about that. There's a few of those. Or like
the cross-eyed one for sure.
The licking the male adhesives.
What's that one?
I was told that would make you like really ill as a kid.
It'll make you really sick.
But it doesn't. It just tastes bad.
Well, there you go, guys. Yeah. Lies that parents told us. What is a lie that your parents told you? Leave in the comments down below.
Dude, I just realized you didn't put the one on there from my sister. You must not have found it.
What is it?
It was really funny. It said, I love you. All right, take care, y'all. Peace out, Mud Scouts.
Oh. It's a cucumber. A cucumber come
through. Did you guys do this? Did you guys? All right.
They got us a cucumber. All right.
Thanks, guys.
It was for you.